This case, the Japanese example, is which there are parallels with Chinese history, I think, which is that during the Opium Wars in the middle of the 19th century, like all other Asians, the Japanese had to figure out what they were going to do about overwhelming Western power and how to avoid being dominated by it. Mm. And so they made a study of what, in their view, made European countries so powerful. And they came to the conclusion that it was because of Christianity. And Christianity was clearly the state faith, and that's what made people obedient to their rulers and created moral order. And that's why and China was decadent and all the rest of it, decrepit and so on, weak. And so, Japan. And therefore, what the Japanese needed was their own state religion, their own form of Christianity, in other words.
Hence Shinto.
Shinto, because Buddhism wouldn't do, because that was foreign. Mm. And so they took this sort of set of, basically, a sort of nature cult and made that into the state faith. But it's not just a Shintoist way of thinking, it's a very Confucian way of thinking, because it means that for a state to be powerful, it needs to have a spiritual
center
order.
Of gravity. Or
yeah,
something. Yeah.
And I think I don't know what you think, but it may be that Yuan Zhiming and other Christian dissidents take a similar view of Christianity.
Yes, many people who converted were influenced by the Tiananmen massacre, and they felt many of these people were. Political, they thought China's salvation lay in democracy, lay in a political upheaval or change of power. And then they felt after Tiananmen that this had failed because China had not had a spiritual revolution. We had to have to have a spiritual revolution before we can have a political revolution. So many of them converted. And this includes, Yuan Zhiming is a great example. He had been a documentary filmmaker in China, had made that famous or been one of the people who helped make that famous TV series, River Elegy, which challenged traditional Chinese culture. And then when he went abroad, he converted. But many other people were affected as well. And another thing then, for a newer generation, was the earthquake in Sichuan in 2008. That there was this feeling that the state had failed, that the state had not responded properly, and that faith-based groups had raced to the scene before the government, and that they had reacted better, and that faith-based communities were therefore more effective. And this was a big spur for many Christian groups in China, but not just Christian groups, but other faith-based groups as well.